Allô. Bismillah. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وسيق الذين اتقوا ربهم إلى الجنة زمرا. حتى إذا جاءوها وفتحت أبوابها وقال لهم خزنتها سلام عليكم طبتم فادخلوها خالدين. وقالوا الحمد لله الذي صدقنا وعده وأورثنا الأرض نتبوأ من الجنة حيث نشاء فنعم أجر العاملين. وسيق الذين اتقوا ربهم إلى الجنة زمرا. حتى إذا جاءوها وفتحت أبوابها وقال لهم خزنتها سلام عليكم وفتحت أبوابها وقال لهم خزنتها سلام عليكم طبتم فادخلوها وسيق الذين اتقوا ربهم إلى الجنة زمرا حتى وفتحت أبوابها وقال لهم خزنتها سلام عليكم طبتم وفتحت أبوابها وقال لهم خزنتها سلام عليكم طبتم سلام عليكم طبتم فادخلوها خالدين وقالوا الحمد لله الذي صدقنا وعده وقالوا الحمد لله الذي صدقنا وعده وأورثنا الأرض نتبوأ من الجنة حيث نشاء فنعم أجر العاملين وقالوا الحمد لله الذي صدقنا وعده وقالوا الحمد لله الذي صدقنا وعده وأورثنا الأرض نتبوأ من الجنة حيث نشاء فنعم أجر العاملين وترى الملائكة حافين من حول العرش يسبحون وترى الملائكة حافين من حول العرش يسبحون وترى الملائكة حافين من حول العرش يسبحون بحمد ربهم يُسَبِّحُونَ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّهِمْ وَقُضِيَ بَيْنَهُمْ بِالْحَقِّ وَقِيلَ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن للمتقين مفازا حدائق وأعنابا وكواعب أترابا وكأسا دهاقا إن للمتقين مفازا حدائق وأعنابا وكواعب أترابا وكأسا دهاقا لا يسمعون فيها لغوا ولا كذابا وكأسا دهاقا لا يسمعون فيها لغوا ولا كذابا جزاء من ربك عطاء حسابا رب السماوات والأرض رب السماوات والأرض وما بينهما الرحمن لا يملكون منه خطابا يوم يقوم الروح يوم يقوم الروح والملائكة صفا لا يتكلمون والملائكة صفا لا يتكلمون إلا من أذن له الرحمن وقال صوابا. يوم يقوم الروح والملائكة صفا يوم يقوم الروح والملائكة صفا لا يتكلمون إلا من أذن له الرحمن والملائكة صفا لا يتكلمون إلا من أذن له الرحمن وقال صوابا. ذلك اليوم الحق فمن شاء اتخذ إلى ربه مآبا. إنا أنذرناكم عذابا قريبا يوم ينظر المرء ما قدمت يداه يوم ينظر المرء ما قدمت يداه ويقول الكافر يا ليتني كنت ترابا. صدق الله العظيم. الفاتحة. يا سيد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم.
أكبر ما شاء الله. أنت خدت الميكروفون بقى. جزاك الله خير يا شيخ، بارك الله فيك.
يلا. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. جزاكم الله خير for coming to the house of Allah سبحانه وتعالى to listen to this beautiful recitation of the Holy Quran, especially these days. And I would like, before I start this خاطر إن شاء الله, to thank our Sheikh, Sheikh Ahsan, Jazallah Khair, for giving us this good opportunity to meet with you again and to sit with you in this beautiful Islamic center here in the heart of California, Los Angeles, inshallah. I would love to thank also the leadership of the committee, executive committee of the masjid, for allowing us also to come. Jazakumullah khair, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you all and protect your families all, inshallah, for this great and good gathering to recite and to listen to the Holy Quran, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. Dear brothers, dear sisters, Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, we have to know as Muslims, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Ghafoor, Rahim, Wadood, Kareem. And because of that, He is creating too many stations in our life to be forgiven. You remember Sheikh Ahsan when he was leading the Salah here, Taraweeh, Ramadan, Tahajjud, Qiyam, and MashaAllah, SubhanAllah, after Ramadan and after these good deeds, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not create us and did not leave us in the middle of nowhere. And they said, no, another session is coming. The days of the Hijjah and the Hajj. During the week, Monday, Thursday, you can fast 13, 14, 15 every month. Allahu Akbar. You can make hasanat, good deeds, through your sadaqah, charity, istighfar, Quran recitation. يعني عدد أعمال الخير كعدد أنفاس الخلائق. There is no limit for making good deeds at all. It's endless. يعني سبحان الله. Do whatever you أعملوا ما شئتم. إنه بما تعملون بصير. Our life, dear brothers, dear sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that our life exactly when you go to Costco, right? Did you go to Costco before? In a store? And you have your card and you get all merchandise. Fill it. Don't worry. Whatever you like, you desire, just to put it inside that card. Just. But in the end, what's going to happen? You have the cashier close to the door, right? You have to pay. There is nothing free, right? So that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, اعملوا مشيتم. Do whatever you want. That's why He gave us, Almighty Azza wa Jal, choice in this worldly life, right? You have a choice. Nobody forced me or forced you to come to the masjid tonight. You came by your choice, right? But since you die, since I die, there is no choice with you. That's it. The malaika will handle you. Even the questioning of the graves. Until you go to Jannah. Since you go to Jannah, you have a choice again. Somebody gonna go to hellfire, there is no choice for him. You're gonna be punished. That's it. So that's why you have to know what's going on with you. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, out of His mercy and rahmah, He's creating these stations in our life to be forgiven. Alhamdulillah, we are into His rahmah nowadays. These first 10 days of the Hijjah. Making good deeds in these days better than al-jihad fi sabilillah. I'm sure Sheikh was covering all of this subject too many times. But just let's come to the point here. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is creating this, why? Because you answer yourself, we are weak. Allah said that in the Quran clearly. وَخُلِقَ الْإِنسَانُ ضَعِيفًا. Because of your weakness, while you are being surrounded by too many enemies. Do I have enemies? No, too many. قال إن ابتليت بأربع ما سلطوا إلا لشدة شقوتي وعنائي إبليس والدنيا ونفسي والهوى كيف الخلاص وكلهم أعدائي. If you have these four enemies, how can you be survive? إبليس, شيطان is your enemy. Manifest enemy. عدو مبين. He's not hidden. Number two, والدنيا, this worldly life and what's temptations and attractions. Allah. A lot of fitna nowadays. ونفسي, my nafs, خربانة هاي. نفس الخبيثة بقى واللوامة بقى. سبحان الله. والهوى, my desire. Quran talks about الهوى. أفرأيت من اتخذ إله وهوى وأضله الله على عين. لا إله فأنت تكون عليه وكيلة. لا إله إلا الله. الهوى could be God. People they are falling their desires, worshipping their desires. For these enemies, we've been surrounded by these enemies, their brothers and sisters. How to be survived? Allah, out of His mercy, He's creating these stations for us to be forgiven. Not just that. The scholars, they said, التوبة itself, it's one of these stations. Seeking forgiveness in this worldly life, one of these stations, to be forgiven. الحسنات الممحيات. Whenever you make good deeds, that will wipe out your sins, subhanAllah. And any kind of hardship also, calamities in your life, that will wipe out your sin. Salat al-janazah after her death. The fitna of al-munkar wal-nakir. And also that hasanat or gifts will come to you through somebody. Sa'd ibn Ubadah said, Ya Rasulullah, my mom died. Can I make sadaqah for her? He said, go. In her behalf? Yes, no. فَكَانَتْ سِقَيَةُ سَعْدِ بِالْمَدِينَةِ سِقَيَةُ سَعْدِ بِنْ عَبَادَةِ. You know? The day of judgment, and it's a terrible day, subhanAllah. The accountability itself in the hereafter, when you stand before Allah and He will ask you, عَبْدِي, didn't I do that and this and this and this for you? Why you're coming to me with the bad things and you're going to the people with the good things? And Allah will count and ask you, you're going to have that fear in your heart. The shafa'a of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his intercession, that also Allah will wipe out your sin. Not just that, the shafa'a of the shaheed, the scholars, the ulama, the salihin, the anbiya, the mursaleen, they're going to have shafa'at too, intercessions. And the end, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, shafa'a al-anbiya wal-mursaloon, wa-wa-wa-wa, afala a'fu ana? The pardoning of Allah. أخرجوا من النار من كان في قلبه مثقال حبة من خردل من إيمان. Get out from the hellfire. Anybody has like a weight of an atom of iman in his heart. فالله كريم رحيم ودود. He's not creating us without any messenger or book or guide. No. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is putting you in the sirat al-mustaqim because there are too many enemies around you. This is out of his love. لو خلقتموهم لرحمتموهم والله. Allah said to the angels, if you create them, you're going to have mercy on them. Because we are so weak. Tomorrow, inshallah, not tomorrow, we are in the night of the day of Arafah now. Yes, we are into the mercy from now, mashallah. That's why stay, she's going to recite, inshallah, Quran again. This night of the Quran, actually. Tomorrow is the day of Arafah. This is the night of the day of Arafah, inshallah. The day of Arafah, in that day, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, if you fast the day of Arafah, don't miss it, please. Brothers and sisters, don't miss the day of Arafah. If you fast that day, you will be forgiven for 2 years. 2 years, the current year and the previous year. Allahu Akbar. Who can make this deal with us? It's a deal. Couple of hours, you will be forgiven for 2 years. Allahu Akbar. Allah Kareem, Rahim. Wadud, He loves us. He loves us. And He want to purify us from our sins. Sheikh was reciting the last ayat of Surah Al-Zumar. وَسِيقَ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا رَبَّهُمْ إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ زُمَرًا حَتَّى إِذَا جَاءُوهَا وَفُتِحَتْ أَبْوَابُهَا وَقَالَ لَهُمْ خَزَنَتُهَا سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ طِبْتُمْ فادخلوها خالدين. شوف الآية هنا طيبتم. طيبتم because you've been purified, you are allowed to enter Jannah. Nobody will, take it from me, nobody will enter Jannah while he has sin. Because the Jannah is pure. And you have to be pure to enter Jannah. طيبتم. طيبتم. For that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is creating too many ways, stations in our life, even after our death, even thereafter, to be purified. So you have to put yourself into this rahmah. Arafah, inshallah tomorrow. That day, it's a great day. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala perfected his deen in that day. It was Friday, day of Arafah. Rasulullah and the Sahaba, they were standing above the mountain of Arafat. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent this ayat. Al-yawma akmaltu lakum deenakum wa atmamtu alaykum ni'mati wa raditu lakum al-islam deena. Ni'mati, my ni'mah. When he talks about the deen, he said, my ni'mah, ni'mati, subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala perfected our deen on that day. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be proud of the pilgrims and those who are making hasanat and good deeds in that day, and those who are fasting that day, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah azza wa jal swear in the Quran by these days. He said, wal fajr. He swears by the best time of your day, which is Salat al-Fajr. How many of us who are missing Salat al-Fajr? Wal-Fajr, wal-Fajr, Salat al-Fajr. Allah swears by Salat al-Fajr. Wal-Azim la yuqsim illa bi'azim. Because he's great, he's the greatest. And he swears by something great, Salat al-Fajr. The best time of your day. Wal-Layalin Ashr. The scholars, the mosques, they said, these 15 days. وَالشَّفْعِ وَالْوَتْرِ Some of us say the Shafi'i, the day of Eid, because it's even the 10th. وَالْوَتْرِ Some of them, they say the Ad, which is the day of Arafah, tomorrow, 9th of the Hijjah. وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا يَسْرِ The last third of every night. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is descending to our heaven, He's offering you three things. هَلْ مِن مُسْتَغْفِرْ هَلْ مِن تَائِبْ هَلْ مِن سَائِلْ لَا إِلَهِ إِلَّا اللَّهِ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one He is free from all kind of needs. He's offering you. You are in need to Him. And He's the one He's offering you, Almighty Azza wa Jalla. Dear brother, dear sisters, we have to know the value of our a'mal and our hasanat and these deeds. Subhanallah, it's little, but it's vast, deep. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you a lot of ajr because of that. And this is big barakah, blessings for this ummah. Little a'mal, great deeds, Allahu Akbar. Don't miss it. You're going to be a loser if you miss these days. Tomorrow, inshallah, after Zawal from Zuhr time to Salat al-Maghrib, 8 o'clock, what time, how many hours? 7 hours? If you count it, 7 hours? These 7 hours, subhanallah, from after Zawal to Salat al-Maghrib tomorrow, just make yourself busy. 7 hours, that's it, you make it. While you're fasting, dua. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, خَيْرُ الدُّعَاءِ دُعَاءُ يَوْمِ عَرَفَةِ خَيْرُ الدُّعَاءِ دُعَاءُ يَوْمِ عَرَفَةِ The best of your dua, that dua you make it in the day of Arafah. Very powerful, powerful. Subhanallah. And he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَخَيْرُ مَا قُلْتُ أَنَا وَالنَّبِيُّونَ مِنْ قَبْلِي لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ وَحْدَهُ لَا شَرِيكَ لَهُ لَهُ الْمُلْكُ وَلَهُ الْحَمْدُ وَهُوَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ The best of your dua, the dua of the day of Arafah. Huh? From after the Zawal, start raise your hand. And Rasulullah, when he used to make the dua, Abdullah ibn Abbas, he saw Rasulullah standing above the mountain of Arafat, making dua like this. He was putting his hand close to his chest like somebody's begging for money. Huh? He was putting his hand close to his chest like that. Ya Allah, Ya Allah. And he saw him, subhanAllah, is holding the robe of his camel with hand and putting another hand in dua like this. He did not miss second. On the day of Arafah, for making dua. Make dua for yourself, for your family, for your community, for the entire Muslim ummah. Make dua, brothers and sisters. Tomorrow is the day of dua. Very powerful. Make it, Allah will answer, inshallah. He will give you and He will fulfill your needs. Whatever you need, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give it to you. Don't miss tomorrow. And the best of what Rasulullah used to say with the anbiya before him, The Anbiya before him, yes, because the Anbiya, they used to make Hajj also, since Adam. Musa, Isa, Jana, Prophet Jana, subhanAllah, Yunus, there are too many hadith. They used to make, alayhi salam, they used to make Hajj. For Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the best of what I say, the dua, and the Anbiya before me, لا إله إلا الله. Repeat this tomorrow. لا إله إلا الله. وحده لا شريك له. له الملك وله الحمد. وهو على كل شيء قدير. These days also, يعني I don't know but repeat myself. I'm sure Sheikh Ahsan is one of the scholars in the community here in Los Angeles. ما شاء الله جزاه الله خير. May Allah bless him. I'm following your masjid. I'm part of you here. I know, ما شاء الله, he's covering all of this subject. I'm sure, ما شاء الله, he's giving you a lot of knowledge. يعني. I don't want to repeat what he said. يعني جزاه الله خير. What I'm saying here is these days also the days of submission. The main point of Eid al-Adha and all of that. Submission. These days, how to submit yourself, your face, your heart, your body to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And a good example for that, we start with Lady Hajar, Sayyidah Hajar radiallahu anha. When she left Palestine with Sayyidina Ibrahim, Taban used to live in Egypt and she was one of the princes of Egyptian people. If you study the Egyptian history, she was one of the princes. She was not a maid or anything like what they say, no. Radiallahu anha. And she being gifted to Sayyidina Ibrahim and Sarah. Subhanallah, when she get Ishmael, the infant baby, as you know the story, the order came to Sayyidina Ibrahim, take your wife and the infant baby, both them, where is Mecca now? بُوَادٍ غَيْرِ ذِي زَرَعٍ عِنْدَ بَيْتِكَ الْمُحَرِّ Subhanallah. And he lifted her. Long story short, just to show you the submission, my point. She told him, Ya Ibrahim, grab of little dates and some water. And he lifted her, his wife, and her his infant baby.
Ya Ibrahim, did Allah ask you to do that? Allah, amaraka bihada? Tears. Yes, he did. She said, look, we learn from Hajar. Idhan lan yudayyuna. Then Allah will help us. Allahu Akbar. Idhan lan yudayyuna. That's it. Until now, until the day of judgment, inshallah, we are imitating Hajar between Safa and Marwa. But I was in Hajj before Corona. I'm sorry to say that. Brothers and sisters taking pictures. And they're making fun. And they're telling us stories between Safa and Marwa. I told them I was with 130 people. I told them, guys, don't do this. I want you to remember Hajar. How Hajar was begging Allah, crying, tearing her baby son, Ismail, infant, crying. And she was in fear. Alone in that valley, nobody was there. I want you to feel the same feeling of Hajar. Beg Allah, Ya Rab, forgive me. Ya Rab, I'm miskeen. Ya Rab, I'm poor. Ya Rab, forgive my sin. While you're coming and going between Safa and Marwa, and take picture. I'm here. What is this? This is not good. People, they are doing the harakat, but they doesn't understand the meaning of al-Hajj. Each thing and everything in Hajj has a point. Why we are making it? Between Safa and Marwa, remember Hajar, and we are imitating her until that. It's a big honor. She passed the test. After that, subhanallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was talking about Ismail and Sayyidina Ibrahim. فَلَمَّا بَلَغَ مَعَهُ السَّعِي بَلَغَ مَعَهُ السَّعِي means Sayyidina Ibrahim, every while he used to visit Hajar to Mecca and he used to come back. He did not leave them just a bit. So every while he used to visit them. When he became, mashallah, young boy, Sayyidina Ismail, he said, I saw in my dream another test to slaughter you. And he was the only son for him. Subhanallah. Some people look like Ismail, Isaac was first. No. Ismail, alayhi salam, he was the first son of Sayyidina Ibrahim. And he did not have, Isaac during that time. The story talks in the Quran about Ismail, only Ismail. Zabih, that's it. You know, people, they are talking too much. It's not right. فالمهم, you know the story. The point, Sayyidina Ismail said, قَالَ يَا أَبَتِ فَعَلْ مَا تُؤْمَرْ. It's order from Allah. I'm listening. سَتَجِدُونِي إِنْ شَاءَ اللَّهِ قَدَّمَ الْمَشِيئَةِ. I have muscles. He was a big fighter, Sayyidina Ismail. Strong. بس قدم المشيئة أدبا. أدب مع الأب مع الإبن. سبحان الله. The point here is submission. Ismail, he submitted himself to Allah. Ibrahim alayhi salam, the father, he submitted himself to Allah. Hajar before, full submission. These days, submit to the order of Allah. This is good for you in dunya and the akhirah. Obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I would love to congratulate any young and youth who is coming to the masjid and praying, and the sister, she's having hijab and cover and listening to her husband and taking care of her family. And that person is away from any kind of temptations or fitna or anything. These days, we have to remember that the oneness of Allah, Tawheed. Sayyidina Ibrahim came with the Tawheed. وَلِإِنَّ صَلَاتِ وَنُسُكِ وَمَحْيَايَ وَمَمَاتِ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ لَا شَرِيكَ لَهُ وَبِذَلِكَ أُمِرْتُ وَأَنَا أَوَّلُ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. So we know, we have to know that, the value of what we're doing. I'm asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I would love to talk a lot, but Sheikh is here. It's a good opportunity for us also to listen to him. Inshallah, I will give the microphone to the Sheikh to recite more Quran, inshallah, until Salat al-Asha. Jazakum Allah khair. Barakallah fiqh. Allah hafazkum, inshallah.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ربنا إني أسكنت من ذريتي بواد غير ذي زرع عند بيتك المحرم ربنا إني أسكنت من ذريتي بواد غير ذي زرع أسكنت من ذريتي بواد غير ذي زرع عند بيتك المحرم ربنا ليقيموا الصلاة ربنا ليقيموا الصلاة فاجعل أفئدة من الناس تهوي إليهم وارزقهم من ثمرات لعلهم يشكرون ربنا إني أسألت من ذريتي بواد غير ذي زرع عند بيتك المحرم ربنا ليقيموا الصلاة ربنا إني أسكنت من ذريتي بواد غير ذي زرع عند بيتك المحرم ربنا ليقيموا الصلاة ربنا ليقيموا الصلاة ربنا ليقيموا الصلاة فاجعل أفئدة من الناس تهوي إليهم وارزقهم من الثمرات لعلهم يشكرون
يا رب يا رب
وارزقهم من الثمرات وارزقهم من الثمرات لعلهم يشكرون ربنا إنك تعلم ما نخفي وما نعلن ربنا إنك تعلم ما نخفي وما نعلن وما يخفى على الله الحمد لله الحمد لله الذي وهب لي على الكبر إسماعيل وإسحاق الحمد لله الذي وهب لي على الكبر إسماعيل وإسحاق إن ربي لسميع الدعاء رب اجعلني مقيم الصلاة ومن ذريتي ربنا وتقبل دعاء ربنا وتقبل دعاء يا ربنا اغفر لي ولوالدي وللمؤمنين يوم يقوم الحساب رب اجعلني مقيم الصلاة ومن ذريتي ربنا وتقبل بل دعاء ربنا وتقبل دعاء ربنا اغفر لي ولوالدي ربنا اغفر لي ولوالدي وللمؤمنين يوم يقوم الحساب ولا تحسبن الله غافلا عما يعمل الظالمون إنما يؤخرهم ليوم تشخص فيه الأبصار إنما يؤخرهم ليوم تشخص فيه الأبصار مهطعين مقنعي رؤوسهم مهطعين مقنعي رؤوسهم لا يرتد إليهم طرفهم لا يرتد إليهم طرفهم وأفئدتهم هواء وأنذر الناس يوم يأتيهم العذاب فيقول الذين ظلموا ربنا أخرنا ربنا أخرنا إلى أجل قريب نجب دعوتك ونتبع الرسل أولم تكونوا أقسمتم من قبل ما لكم من زوال وسكنتم في مساكن الذين ظلموا أنفسهم وتبين لكم كيف فعلنا بهم وضربنا لكم الأمثال وقد مكروا مكرهم وعند الله مكرهم وإن كان مكرهم لتزول منه الجبال فلا تحسبن الله مخلف وعده رسله إن الله عزيز ذو انتقام يوم تبدل الأرض غير الأرض والسماوات وبرزوا لله الواحد القهار الفاتحة
سيد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم.